So if I go into screens and then configure screens, you will notice that I have 5 screens set up right now. And each of them does work perfectly fine. Notice I've got 3 here on the left for the audience and 2 here on the left for the stage. I'm going to add another one. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how many screens can you add in ProPresenter? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been curious how many screens you can add, or if you added one more and it didn't seem to work right, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments before. Like and subscribe as well. So when ProPresenter 7, which we're on 18 now, but it's a variant of 7. It's basically 7.18, really, when you think about it. When ProPresenter 7 was announced, Renewed Vision said, well, basically, you can add as many screens as you want. That's kind of true and kind of not true. So let's head over to my computer and we'll talk about that and the limitations that we have. So if I go into screens and then configure screens, you will notice that I have 5 screens set up right now. And each of them does work perfectly fine. Notice I've got 3 here on the left for the audience and 2 here on the left for the stage. I'm going to add another one. And since I don't have an infinite number of outputs, I could, because I've got a DeckLink Duo, I could do 4 screens plus 4 that are built into the computer plus 1 more just because of this particular computer, how it's set up. But I'm going to do just placeholder screens. So right there, and let's add a 720p placeholder. So that gets me to 6 screens. And let's add a couple more placeholders down here. Actually, let me do a siphon screen here for the stage screen. And let me add one more. This one I'll make an NDI screen. So now I have 8 screens. And with those 8 screens, if I go to a song here, notice that that's showing something. That's showing something. That's actually this TV next to me. That's showing something. That's showing something. It's routed a little bit differently, but it is still showing something. That's showing something. That is. And this is. So that's 8 screens. No problem. Working perfectly fine. So that's good. So what's the problem? Well, let's head back into configure screens, because notice that's 8 screens. Going back into configure screens, I'm going to add a 9th screen down here. And it won't let me. In earlier versions, it would let you add the 9th screen, but it wouldn't actually do anything. So here on the left-hand side, we have a limit of 8. Now, I could do 7 audience screens and 1 stage screen. I could do 7 stage screens and 1 audience screen. I can mix and match them, but there is a limit of 8. So that's 8 on the left-hand side. But let me show you a way to add more screens. So for this screen right here, notice that all of these were set up as single screens. What if I go to mirror? If I go to mirror, then I can add in another placeholder if I want to. And those will both work. They'll always show the same thing, but they will both work. if instead of mirrored, I went to grouped. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So, head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Notice I can change the number of rows and change the number of columns. And then this is basically considered one big screen, even though it by itself has six other little screens. So I could format things so that it puts stuff right here, it puts different stuff right there, it puts different stuff right there. And notice that I can, again, add another placeholder screen if I wanted to. So I can add more screens here in the right two-thirds of this screen, and I could kind of get around the limitations. Edge blend, same thing. This is considered one screen, even though it's made up of five screens. So that's the way to get around it. It's at least one way to get around it, rather. Let me show you the other way to get around it. So if we go back to ProPresenter and Settings or Preferences up here and go to Network. I have network link here. So I don't have another ProPresenter machine running right now, but if I did, that second ProPresenter machine could also have 8 outputs. So that could be 16. I could add a third ProPresenter machine with 8 more. So that's 24, etc., etc. So while there is a limit of how many screens you can add in configure screens on the left-hand side. Here, let me, I'm just going to right-click on this to delete it, just to show you this. Notice that now I can add a fifth screen here for the audience. So, as long as there's the number here on the left is 8 or less, you're good. Once you try and add more, it just won't do it, so you've got to get creative, either using the group screen or mirrored screen. Although most of the time I tell people if you need to just mirror a screen, just buy a splitter. That'll take some of the heavy lifting of drawing those pixels off of your computer. Maybe give your computer a little bit longer lifespan in that it won't, sometime in the future, when the updates of the OS start causing things to slow down, when new features start causing things to slow down, the splitter will not do that, because from the computer's perspective, it's just one screen. So keep that in mind. So you could add in mirrored screens, although maybe not all that helpful. You can add in group screens. That's the first hack. Or you can use network link with another ProPresenter seat and get 8 more. Either way, that's how you could do that in ProPresenter. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I will make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.